This is a f***ed up situation. But Russia's invasion of Ukraine has shown that more and more combat will be done by unmanned robots. Just like in Hollywood movies. This is just a movie, but it's actually a pretty accurate portrayal of what weapons might look like in the near future.
We're talking about weapons that, once programmed by a human, would then make a decision on their own about which specific targets to attack without any further human intervention.
And when I say near future, I mean now. You might ask, why are we doing this? Well, for most of human history, war has just been a giant meat grinder. Masses of humans and their sidekicks trying desperately to kill each other with sticks, rocks, swords, now bombs and guns. The promise of precision weapons is to reduce the overall horror of war. But with this trajectory, is Skynet about to go online?
Is it acceptable for a machine to make life and death decisions in war? There are many situations in war that are gray. And that's a real challenge when it comes to autonomous weapons. How would a robot know the difference between what's legal and what's right? How would it know to tell the difference?
I mean, what could go wrong? This is Hard Reset, a series about rebuilding our world from scratch. This is Paul Scharre. He's spent a lot of time working in places like this funky five-sided building, advising people on policy around robotics, automation, and the future of warfare.
When people worry about autonomous weapons, one of the fears would be robots running amok and killing civilians, the sort of things you see in Terminator movies. No one's building that. That's the good news.
That's exactly what Skynet would have you believe, Paul. But anyway, autonomous weapons have actually been around for a long time. For example, landmines. They're not intelligent, but once they're armed and placed by a human, they work on their own. But of course, landmines are f***ing awful. Why would we want more autonomous weapons?
One of the arguments for autonomous weapons is that just like someday self-driving cars could reduce accidents on roads, perhaps machines could do the same in war. And autonomous weapons could avoid civilian casualties, making war more precise and more humane. In World War II, nations bombed entire cities and killed hundreds of thousands of civilians. One of the unfortunate realities of the technology of the time was bombing was not very precise. Today, advanced militaries can actually place a bomb precisely where they want to. Moving forward, militaries are developing next-generation robotic combat systems that would use more autonomy. How much autonomy is not always clear when looking at their plans. Senior Russian military leaders have said that their intention is to build fully roboticized units that are capable of independent operations. The US military now has in its naval fleet a ship called the Sea Hunter, a totally autonomous ship. Swarms are the next step in military robotics. And people are experimenting with what this might look like and how it would dramatically change military tactics in warfighting. How do you fight with a swarm? What are the commands to give a swarm? How do swarms fight each other? What are the best tactics for swarm warfare? The idea of handing a lethal weapon to a computer would seem on the face of it potentially risky and problematic. We want to be mindful of risks, but we also don't want to sort of foreclose the opportunity that there may be ways to make war more precise and more humane and save civilian lives in the process.
As this technology evolves, we have to think about how involved humans should be when technology takes a life. Are there things we just don't want machines to decide without us?
I saw things firsthand in war that I don't think machines could deal with. Situations that I faced that I think are too complex, that require human judgment and moral understanding. There was an incident early in the war in Afghanistan where I was part of an Army Ranger sniper team. And on one mission, we infiltrated at night. And when sun came up, we were pretty exposed. Now, what we expected to happen was that some fighters would come to attack us, and we were ready for that. What we didn't expect was they sent a little girl to scout at our position. as she walked around us, she would sort of stare at us. And we heard what we later realized was the chirping of a radio that she had on her, reporting back information about us. Eventually, she left. And not long after, some Taliban fighters did come. And we took care of them. But later, we were talking about what we would do in a similar situation like that. If we came across someone and we didn't know if they were a civilian and they were scouting for the enemy, what would we do? Something that never came up in conversation was the idea of shooting this little girl. The laws of war don't set an age for combatants. You know, what's interesting is if you programmed a robot to comply perfectly with the laws of war, it would have killed this little girl. And I think that's wrong. I think that would have been morally wrong. If we had a war and no one felt bad about the fact that we were killing other human beings, what would that say about us? What would it say about us if no one slept uneasy at night afterwards?
Right now, the United States is not building lethal autonomous weapons.
War presents lots of complex moral challenges that people face. And I don't really think that any machines that we see today or in the foreseeable future will be able to deal with those challenges. Not because the machines cannot make those decisions, but because they shouldn't. These moments of humanity seem important. They seem like something that we wouldn't want to give up. It's an opportunity for humans to exercise empathy and recognize the humanity of the other side.
But if the history of war has taught us anything, it's that just because we don't want a technology to be used for killing people, that doesn't mean it won't be.
We've seen throughout history that there are many times when in peacetime, militaries say, we're not going to use this kind of technology. For World War I, we won't use poison gas. Yet once the shooting started and poison gas was available, militaries started using it. Prior to World War II, military said they wouldn't do aerial attacks on cities.
A short time ago, an American airplane dropped one bomb on Hiroshima and destroyed its usefulness to the enemy.
In the course of interviewing experts for Army of None, the former director of research at the Office of Naval Research, Larry Schutte, asked the really important question of, when we're thinking about autonomous weapons, is it December 6th or December 8th?
Flash, Washington. The White House announces Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor.
Is it before or after this game-changing event that might change how we think about risk and what we're willing to tolerate in warfare?
Come back next time for another episode of Hard Reset. Subscribe to Freethink to watch our other original series and documentaries about technology and people that are changing our world.